Hi, I'm Jake, and what is that smell? Well, it's garbage, and there is a lot of garbage. According to the EPA, the US produces 250 million tons of trash a year before recycling. That's the weight of a million blue whales or 700 Empire State Building. It's a lot. And globally, it's about 2 billion tons, so about 8 million blue whales and 5,500 Empire State Buildings. That's around 5 pounds of trash per person per day. You can check out the approximate amount of waste that's been produced this year at theworldcounts.com, which is all sorts of numbers about how good old planet Earth is doing and what we're doing to keep it safe. But that's just one trashy dong, and boy, do I have a whole bin of dongs for you. Something you can do online now, guys. So we know there's a lot of garbage, but where does it all go? Well, about 30% gets recycled, which is awesome, and millions of pounds of refuse gets processed every year at recycling plants all over the planet. Now, this game over at berecycled.org gives you an idea of how reusable material is sorted and how different machines get the job done. Although the game isn't totally accurate to how a recycling plant looks, each of the machine's jobs reflect a step in the recycling process. The disc screens represent a much longer process of separating and sorting paper and cardboard that involves vibrating a giant container full of all the recyclables, which separates the paper from heavier materials. The gravity sorter represents the glass bottles that are allowed to fall through due to their weight. These are destroyed and separated. Next, a big magnet pulls metal cans off the conveyor belt, and the optical scanners detect plastic bottles and separate them from the conveyor with a gust of air. So reusing our old stuff is great, but what about the trash that doesn't get recycled? Although there are plenty of materials that should be recycled, they end up in the trash anyway. But there's a bunch of materials that can't be recycled, things like food, plastic bags, styrofoam, and certain types of paper. Most of this junk ends up in landfills, but a lot of it ends up in the ocean. Though there aren't any Isle of Dog-style islands of garbage out in the high seas, there is so much more trash accumulated in certain spots that one of them has a name, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, also known by a cooler name, the Pacific Trash Vortex. TheOceanCleanup.com has a lot of great info on this crazy mess. Due to the fact that most of the debris is tiny pieces of dissolved plastic, it may be impossible to know exactly how much garbage is floating out there. But we have a pretty close estimate thanks to various studies to determine its size that have been going on since 1988. Now, most estimates put it anywhere between 700,000 to 15 million square kilometers. Now, that's a pretty big range of sizes, from the size of Texas to the size of Russia, but that's still huge no matter which way you swing it. And a big reason why this kind of accumulation can occur is because of how long it takes plastics to break down. This chart on planetaid.com shows how long it takes for organic materials to biodegrade versus their plastic counterparts. Things like newspapers and apples will degrade in a few weeks to a few years, but plastic bags can take more than 500 years, and a typical glass bottle could take millions of years to break down. Pretty surprising, at least for me. And now the main reason plastics and other artificial materials take so long to break down, if they break down at all, is that after being taken from petroleum and heated, they create very strong carbon-carbon bonds. Creating these bonds is incredibly time and energy intensive. So in nature, most bonds are made of peptide bonds, which usually consist of a carbon and a nitrogen bond. That is easier to break down, but also easier to make. These are the bonds that the microbes that break down organic matter are used to seeing, where the carbon-carbon bonds found in plastic are foreign and therefore unable to be processed. It's getting pretty messy down here on Earth. What if it were possible to just send all of our trash into space? Well, the first problem would be the cost. Writers at The Atlantic estimated it would take $33 quadrillion to get all of our garbage into orbit. And maybe we can pull a Wally and just leave and let the robots take care of it. Pretty lovely robots. Well, I don't recommend running away from your problems, as my dad would say. And space is scary, as my dad would also say. But if you really want to leave, Flight Club can help you prepare for launch. If you played Kerbal Space Program, which is amazing, but were upset that you couldn't design every single detail down to the decimal point, well, good news. This website will scratch that rocket science itch. It's an intensely detailed simulator for how to get a rocket into space, with everything from stages to what kind of fuel you'll use. And I made a rocket of my own. Let's see if I can go to space. Woo! And nope, didn't make it. Well, I'm not a rocket scientist. Sorry, guys, but even if I got up into space, we'd still be in good company because there's a staggering amount of trash in orbit. Most of it, generally commercial satellites and probes from space missions, are still in operation, but a lot of old stuff is still up there doing nothing. And you can see all of it at stuffinspace.com. It's all up there floating around in this giant cloud. Just look at it.
Wow.
If you click on any of the satellites, you can get a bunch of info on the mission that launched it and what else was sent up on that mission. There's an estimated 500,000 artificial satellites above our heads right now. And if we go even further out into space, we can visit Earth's only natural satellite, the moon. Although it's probably not fair to call it garbage, there's a lot of leftover pieces of equipment left behind from the Apollo missions. And you can check them out as well as the exploration paths of the astronauts at Google Moon. You can get info on what the missions were, what they left behind, and why it couldn't be brought back. All right, this has been fun, but I'm gonna go take out my trash. It's really smelly and warm. If you want to take out trash too, I have good news. This game, Garbage Truck, tasks you with racing to the finish line without spilling any of your garbage or destroying your truck. And it turns out there's an incredibly large amount of garbage truck driving simulators. You can check all of them out in the description as well as all the other dongs in this video. And if you want, there's a playlist of dongs right here. Don't forget to stay in school, recycle. Speaking of recycling, our good friend iDubbbz made a video recently about Yoplait containers for yogurt and how squirrels get their heads stuck in them and that it's killing them. So we'll also link to iDubbbz's video down there. It's really great. The man loves squirrels. And you know what? I love you. All of you. And Ian, but all of you. What do I do with my hands? Okay, as always, thanks for garbage.